to feel
GAC, agus to Falcho, Warrove, Hig Park, Naropri, and Shah Nerevikash, Tamajuksul, Gamor, Le Jerushacht, Nistarwal, Erin Walla, and Shah. We're looking forward here to a historic weekend for the Wolfe Tones and St Enda's Club on the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th of May, when we'll be officially reopening our new facilities.
On the 2nd, 3rd, and 4th of May, we'll have, on the Friday evening, we'll have a talk night. With a host of GAA celebrities coming down to the club on the Saturday evening. I'm bringing a few boys down to play a bit of a match against Derry. And on the Sunday then we'll have a great fun day for all families and within the community, and also our minor tournament.
Finian, obviously with your father being Paddy the Legend, he'll have plenty to say on the Friday night. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Well, he doesn't get much to say in the house, so when he comes down here, I'd be very worried for the GAA celebrities if they're going to get much of a word in edgeways. But I do know that there's a former All-Ireland winner with Tyrone coming, and also a former All-Ireland winner with Armagh coming down for the talk night. So it should be a great evening, and hopefully as many people as possible come and hear their views on the upcoming Ulster Championship.
So that's a great night for Friday the 2nd of May, and then on Saturday the 3rd of May, Armagh coming down to officially open the field. As a Tones man, what does it mean to you for Armagh to be coming down?
Well, it's a great honour for to bring Armagh down to our facilities. As everybody will see on the day, they're second to none now. The two pitches are in perfect condition, and it's a great facility then for the children in the future. I remember being chased around the kitchen bringing home clothes from the old pitches. You remember that yourself as well, and the muck and gutters, and maybe matches being called off when they're younger, but I can't see that happening anymore.
Yeah, it's fantastic facilities, as you say then. And so the Armagh will be down then on the Saturday night, and the following day on the Sunday, what's happening?
On the following day we'll have our minor tournament, which we'll have clubs coming from all over Ulster to the Michael Tay Memorial Tournament, and that's a major tournament on the minor calendar for any club to be invited to. So that's a great thing that's happening on the Sunday. And we also then have a fun day with everything you can think of, bouncy castles, slide runs, the whole lot for all the families within the community.
And just you mentioned about the children and the family fun day, what was the underage growing in the towns?
The underage is really flourishing now the last few years. If we even take just our summer camp as an example, with over 100 out last year. And between the football and camogie, we can get as many people involved in the club. It's not only a benefit to the club itself, but of course to the people that are coming down and being part of this great club.
And I also think that during the Armagh match as well, we'll have a couple of exhibition football and camogie games and underage players, so it's a good community.
That's brilliant. That's a brilliant thing that's going to happen. You know, also, hopefully there'll be a very big crowd. If you take Derry are going extremely well, and Armagh not only will be looking to build for the championship, but also a lot of players hopefully coming back from injury, like the likes of James Morgan from Cross and Lane, or Kieran McKeever, and boys have been out, and hopefully Aidan Faulkner as well. Boys have been out for a while, so I'm sure a lot of Armagh supporters will want to come down and see that.
So you're looking forward to a great weekend?
Can't wait
myself. Thanks, Finian.